Here we go. Schlapp den Darkness, verlangen fette Potten Pommes. Dieser Bombardier bin bereit, ich lach mich selber aus. Die alte Galacho. Du duftest fett in der Luft. By your sweet Princess Silke. Das ist der Oh, oh, die Party dritte Etage hin. Guck mal, ja, ja. Lagerfeuer auf dem Partyboot, ja. Gute Laune, hörst du hier? Bloody Friday wird gefeiert, darum kommen wir heute hier. Deine Girls sehen gut aus. Sie sind gut drauf, aber ich bin gut drauf. Und ich fliege, drück die gut ab. Ich stirb meine Friend und ich seh mich gebrochen. Hab in seiner Nächte mit ewige Treue geschworen. Ich hab diesen Winter Talks und was mit dir und wie ihr hier so viel to the shit, das ist mein Leben, sag ich sie. Heute Nacht ist perfekt, ganze Klick ist auf Deck, Vibe und Freak, ich geh nie wieder weg. Ich will hier sein, aber da sein. Möchte ich hier sein und dann da sein. Ich will hier sein, aber da sein. Möchte hier sein und dann da sein. Sommer mit der Nacht umgehen. In the beginning, I wasn't looking. In the beginning, I wasn't noticing there was anything to look at to begin with. I am your sweet Princess Silke. Generous I am sharing, kind and warm and soft-spoken. I am so intelligent that you cannot fathom, yet I share what you can understand. So hold on, watch. I was invited to live with Yiekey. Yes, in a way he said so. Be my wife. In words, never. Yet he aimed for a long-term relationship, he told me himself. And in the beginning, there was a bouquet of flowers on the table. There was a fruit salad from Whole Foods on the table, and a week of glory and sunshine. Oh, he made this fantastical plan when he had invited me to come to visit him for a week. I say, I can a week. Okay. He brought me to amazing places, which most all of them I liked plenty. He got me to Cirque du Soleil my first time. He got me to the most amazing French restaurant, Yummy. It doesn't exist anymore. Yeah, the entire shebang of all the courses and waiters behind each of the commensales, each one with their own timing, all so beautiful. He got me to the boat club. Okay, that was not interesting. We just walked through where he used to go to drink, I guess. I didn't know at the time. He got me to a comedy club. I like comedy, but I did not understand. Because I was fresh in the country, I had no idea about the political implications. I did not know the names of the people in, you know, in the Bay Area talk about, so I wasn't yet equipped for it, but that's okay. He got me here and there, and I very much enjoyed it. The entire time we spent together. His house was neat and clean, orderly, and organized. So in a way, it was welcoming. And once I actually then arrived, because as I arrived to visit, he said that he wanted to make a family. So he wanted me to now live with him. And as I then came, live with him, he had no space for my belongings. He had not a drawer free for me or a place in the closet. I asked him where to put my things. It hurts. It breaks my heart right now. Oh yes, open, you know, clean out some drawers for you. Do it, just take what you want. It hurts my heart. I was too exhausted from Pavarotti and the entire, so long. I was exhausted to consider any negativity, so I moved forward. Now I'm heartbroken as I talk. I can barely breathe. And yet I had to figure about this alcoholism. It was very important to understand it, because without children, I would have left them immediately. But now they had a home.
And now I was dependent on him economically, and now they got used to him. And I did not really want to put the children to a different person or no person at all. And I am a firm believer that you can make things happen when you want to, when both want to. And that I had yet to achieve. It is important that I figured his alcoholism, because without addressing the problem, a solution cannot be found. So the first step for having a clean and healthy relationship is to have a healthy and clean life. And to understand what healthy and clean means is to address what is not clean and healthy, to get rid of those issues. So naming was the situation. In the beginning, I don't know, often, yeah, sometimes maybe, he said, "Oh, we don't have wine. Let me go grab a bottle of red wine for you." That was kind of surprising. My intuition said, Yiekey, why now? Why not earlier in the store? Because now it was late in the evening, and now he was going down to the liquor store all the way at the end of that very street. I wasn't looking because I wasn't expecting anything wrong or false. So he came, and oh surprise, it was a good bottle of red wine. "You can get that at the liquor store? How nice." So it seemed friendly, kind, generous, and caring. Friendly, kind, and caring, it felt, for me. Yeah. The situation is, why did you not have bottles in the house? I think for self-protection. Because he had a case of beer, not many, one. Yeah, which he would pretty much, not empty, but a lot. And then he would get another one. I think he had no more alcohol in the house. I mean, because he did not want to go ahead and drink it. Alcoholics do that. So it was a bottle at a time. So he came with a red wine bottle, and we sat at the living room table, and he prepared a few snacks. Yeah, Trader Joe's, quick in the oven, but that's okay. And so we sat and drank the bottle and had the snacks, and we're happy. That was the beginning. One day, I had to go to that store myself, or was to, or wanted to, or I don't know what it was. I just had to figure. And then I saw what's in that liquor store. Plenty of tiny little bottles of hard alcohol. Yeah, I used to have a little board in my house when I was a teenager. That was like in at the time. But you had like tiny, tiny little things to put in that little board. I don't know how to call this in English. Stick board, sit board, exhibit board. Yeah, maybe in the shape of a dollhouse, but it was a board with little compartments on the wall. Yeah, and that's how it looked in that store. An entire wall full of like these little bottles and on the countertop everywhere. And one time, as I went to his garage, where he used to spend amazing amount of time before I was there. Yeah, as I arrived, I kind of eliminated that from him. To hide in the garage, because he was used to with his ex to hide there for hours. I eliminated that by saying, "No, come up here." But I didn't really say it, but I kind of made it implicit. So one day in his garage, in the trash bin, which was empty, I saw three tiny bottles. I asked him about it, as I was now on the clue of what was going on. And he claimed, "Well, my friend da-da-da gave it to me." And I felt like, oh God. Because, of course, it was a lie. But then again, so what? So your friend, excuse me. When there is a lie, then there is addiction. So little I understood that the little drives to the liquor store to get a bottle of wine for me was just for him to fill up a few of those tiny bottles of hard liquor in between the beer and the wine to satisfy his level of alcoholism. And he Only once I knew he bought a bottle of hard alcohol. Only once. And that was the last time he drank. Otherwise, he would not actually have any large bottle of any hard alcohol ever. So, oh no, I'm in the middle of vocalizing, and I made a pass in my elbow as I moved my body, came onto the iPad, and the song started to play. The little melody in the background. So his little escapades, not really, but his going off to the liquor store was actually to hide his alcoholism from me. And he would buy three different types of alcohol. Yeah, like, I don't know, vodka and whiskey and what else is there? Rum? I don't know. I don't remember. But three different types, because as you well know, it hits you harder when you mix alcohol. So, ojo abierto, eyes wide open. Observe when you are with anybody, want to get to know what he or she is doing. Alcoholics, they hide their shit.
Top of my leg, I'm driving crazy, smoking in